I'm here at the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard, where I caught up with Robert Garcia. Check it out. So tell me about Nonito's fight, Nonito Donaire.
It's a good fight, you know. Nonito wants those big fights. Nonito is already tired of all that people talk and wants those big fights. I know him, and he's motivated to go out and fight the best. He wants the best. If it was up to him, he'd be fighting the Abner Mares, the, you know, Rigos. But those are fights that, for whatever reason is, that can be done, can be made now. They will happen in the future. But you know, he lets Cameron Duncan do his job, and Cameron tells us this is who we're fighting, and Cameron negotiates everything with Top Rank, with the opponent, with whatever he has to do, and always has always done a great job with Nonito, with everybody he manages. So we leave it all up to him. You know, a lot of fans go up to Nonito or go up to Brandon, how come you don't fight this guy? How come you don't fight that guy? Fuck, you know, we're not the promoters, we're not the managers. That's why they hire a great manager to do his job, and we let him do his job, or else we wouldn't need managers. We wouldn't need a promoter. If we could do a fight, we could do it ourselves, then everybody would be happy, but that's just not the way it works.
And I'm sure you know about this, but I'm in England, and I see a headline, Nonito Donaire leaves Robert Garcia. Wait, I refresh it. Correction, Nonito Donaire is with Robert Garcia.
No,
the media kind of got it wrong.
You know, I don't even know. You know, that's something that they have to make a decision. Wow, this is the first time I'm hearing this.
No. Was the media in the Philippines got it wrong?
Well, if it's the best thing for him, then I'm okay for it. I'm okay for it. I love Nonito. His team, his wife, they've been great to me. They've been great. They've been a great team to me. Everybody knows that we get along really good. And but if that was to happen, this is the first time I'm hearing it. But if that was to happen, I'd be more than happy for him. You know, if I know that it's gonna be for his best, because I'm not with him every day. You know, maybe work something out. Maybe I don't know. You know, that's something Cameron, myself, and them, you know, would have to sit down and talk about. But you know, as of right now, you know, I'm with Nonito. He's my fighter and a great champion, and hopefully that is not the way it sounds.
I think it was a mistake.
Doggy.
How's he doing?
Andy, good.
Andy, when are you fighting?
We still don't know.
Well, how was the cruise?
The cruise is dope.
Yeah, hopefully on the September shows that they're having the top
Chavez.
Seven, yeah, the 13, 14, and 15. Hopefully one of those. If not, then hopefully on Brandon's card. You know, this kid needs to stay busy.
They all need to stay busy at that point of their career.
Yeah,
you can't
exactly
fight twice a year. You need to fight.
You've got to be fighting 6 to 8 times a year. Yeah.
When I was in England, I ran into Benny Lira.
He was over there?
Yeah, he was over there. And he told me the story.
Oh, because of the kid, that one.
Joseph Diaz Jr., because he's from El Monte.
You're right.
So he was telling me about how you had your first amateur fight when you were 7 years old.
I had my first amateur fight when I was 5, and then my second amateur fight, I was 7, and that was with him.
And he said
that was the second fight.
That he told you to finish it fast if you want to go to the bathroom, so you just stop the opponent.
I had to go to the bathroom, so I said, hey, Benny, I got to go to the bathroom. He's like, you can't fucking get out of the ring right now. He says, go finish him fast. So I went out, and the second round, I stopped the kid.
Maybe you should try that with your fighters.
I had to go to the bathroom. No, or maybe... Those fighters that do it inside the ring, they pee inside the ring.
Or take a crap inside the ring.
Or take craps inside the ring.
But I have to ask you this. One thing in the Olympics, and it doesn't matter the sport, a lot of the athletes, the day of the event, they couldn't keep their coolness. How do you keep your coolness, Robert? You won a title as a fighter. You've won many, many titles as a trainer. What do you tell your fighters? How do they keep their cool and not lose it the day where it's the most important? Because it's only one opportunity.
I think the advantage of us here, with all myself that I fought and all the experience my dad gave me as a trainer, and the guy seeing the Kelly Pavliks who have already been through that many times, Maidana has been through that. They see Donaire being successful and winning every fight, Brandon winning every fight. So I think that helps a lot. It helps each other. Even though Brandon's already been a world champion and, you know, Kelly has been there, lost it, came back and got, you know, he's been there a little bit longer. So all that is a learning experience. Brandon just told me that Kelly called him the other day and they were just talking. So, you know, that's what they need, talk to each other. Even though I didn't even know they had talked to each other. They talked to each other, and that helps them out, each other out. Brandon could give them personal advice. Kelly could give them experience from boxing, from home, from, you know, personal experience. So I think that itself helps everybody out. Just coming in, Brandon comes in, and my dad is still here.
I saw they were interacting like friends.
Exactly. You know what I mean?
Camaraderie.
I think that's a big plus for all my fighters, and that helps them out.
But it's not easy when you have the one fight to win a title, and you got to keep your cool. Oh, by the way, Mia St. John won yesterday.
Holy God, that's
won,
right. I didn't
she
know.
Won the title. She's a champion, WBC champion.
Won the title and retired.
Yep, won the title and retired.
Okay, I knew they were going to fight. I didn't know that she won. She won a decision?
Unanimous decision.
Unanimous.
She dominated 10 rounds.
That's nice, man. I'm happy for Mia because she won the first fight too.
That's what I told people.
She won the first fight, and they gave Christy Martin that decision.
Don King.
Oh, that's cool, man. That's so fucking cool. I didn't.
You know, Brandon Krause is training her now.
I forgot.
Let me guess. Your name is Rocky. How you doing? Is that Rocky?
That's Tyson. Tyson Marquez.
Yo, stay tuned for more. FightersLibreport.com. I'm Ali Sekback reporting. You can follow me on Twitter @Sekback. Take a step back.